Do they love these pictures?
So, 请大家祷告中，托住他，让他放胆，有智慧，翻译。
Just keep in your prayers, I hope myself.
今天是母亲节，所以我们也讲一篇关于母亲的信息。
Today is Mother's Day, so of course we're going to have a sermon about mothers.
我们先把今天的经文念一遍，请。 有一个利未家的人娶了一个利未女子为妻，那女子生一个儿子，见她俊美，就藏了她三个月，后来不能再藏，就娶了一个除草箱，抹上石漆和石油，将孩子放在里头，把箱子搁在河边的芦荻中。 孩子的姐姐远远站着，要知道他究竟怎样。法老的女儿来到河边洗澡，她的使女在河边行走，她看见箱子在芦荻中，就打发一个婢女拿来。她打开箱子，看见那孩子，孩子哭了，她就可怜他说。 这是希伯来人的一个孩子，法老的女儿说：“可以，同你父亲的孩子的父亲。”要了，法老的女儿对他说：“你把这孩子抱去，我必给你工价，夫人就把孩子去买他。”孩子见长，夫人把他带到法老的女儿那里。 就做了他的儿子，他给孩子起名叫摩西，意思说，您我把他从水里拉上来。这个妈妈叫什么名字？
What was the name of this mother?
我糟糕了，啊，你等一下说，因为没讲，对不对？
The name of the mother is not mentioned in this passage.
等一下，好，没讲，是别的圣经有讲，圣经有两次提到她的名字。
Scriptures actually mention the mother's name twice elsewhere.
有人说,
Some say,
假如我把世界所有的最香的香色藏在一朵花蕊里, 它叫做玫瑰。
Some say, if I take all the fragrances of the world and put them together in one flower, I would call it a rose.
把宇宙最好听的乐曲浓缩在一篇乐章里, 它叫弥赛亚神曲。
If I took all the world's best music and condensed it into one piece, it would be Handel's Messiah.
如果把世上最伟大的爱用一个名词来形容，它叫母亲。If
I could take the world's greatest love and use one word to describe it, I would describe it as mother's love.
所以有一首歌这么说。There's
a song that goes like this.
天上最美是星星。
The stars in the sky.
地上最美是母亲。
But on earth, the most beautiful is the mother's love.
摇亮了孩子的未来。
They bring about the child's future.
摇走了自己的青春。
Using up the prime of their youth.
因为上帝将他的爱。
Because God has taken her love.
浓缩在母亲的心中，
and placed it into her heart.
它是一盏永不熄灭的灯。
She is a light that will never fade.
母亲节不是圣经出来的节气。
Mother's Day is not a holiday that comes from the Bible.
这是美国人的产物。
This is an American invention.
但是非常符合圣经的原则。
But it is very much in line with the principles of the Bible.
所以今天早上我们纪念母亲的爱的时候，也想到上帝的爱。
So today, when we think of the mother's love, we want to think of God's love as well.
我们也想到母亲的责任。
We think of the mother's responsibility.
刚才读的圣经里面，我们用三段来思想模范母亲所具备的条件。
Based on the passage we just read, we want to learn three principles about what an ideal or model mother is.
这个妈妈叫什么名字？
What is the name of this mother?
约基别。
Yochebed.
不容易，因为在圣经里面只出现两次。
Again, it's not easy for us to know because this name only appears twice in scriptures.
好像是一个默默无闻的女性。
She seems like just another anonymous woman.
但是她是非常伟大的母亲。
But she is a very impressive mother.
怎么知道呢？
How do we know this?
第一个，她是对神有信心的人。
First, we can tell that she is a woman of faith.
虽然记载不多。
Although it doesn't say this much.
但希伯来书第十一章。
But in Hebrews chapter 11,
讲了18个信心的伟人。
It mentions 11 people of faith.
只有三位女性。
Out of these 18, only 3 are women.
亚伯兰的太太撒来，还有妓女拉合。
Two of these are Abraham's wife Sarah and Rahab.
其中还有一位就是约基比。
And the last woman is Jochebed.
她被摆在18位有信心人的行列当中。
She was placed in this 18-person hall of fame of faithful people.
好像我们不知道怎么去找她到底信心从何表现。
So we ask ourselves, where can we find the evidence of her faith?
刚才读的圣经里面,
in the passages we just read,
当时因为以色列人一直生, 人口已经对埃及人产生了一种威胁。
During this time, the population of the Jews was exploding rapidly while they lived in Egypt.
所以这个法老呢, 就下了一个非常残忍的命令。
So the king of Egypt, the Pharaoh, he proclaimed a very cruel law.
只要是希伯来人、以色列人生男孩，就要把他弄死。
If a Jewish person gives birth to a male baby, this male baby must be killed.
约基别刚刚不是第一胎，因为这个时候颁布的命令刚好正对着约基别的怀了孩子。
But at this time, Jochebed already had 2 children, and she was pregnant.
但她生下来以后，圣经刚才讲，见她什么？ 俊美就长了3个月。
So when this third child was born, she noticed that this child was a fine child.
俊美，在圣经里面每一次形容到摩西的时候，都提出这个词“俊美”。Several
times in the scriptures, it mentions when Moses was born, he was lovely in the sight of God.
俊美，美丽，可爱，帅，都对嘛哈。
Handsome, charming, beautiful, lovely.
NSB 这本翻译本说，他在上帝眼中是一个特殊的人。
Other scriptures say that he was no ordinary child.
是一个非常宝贝的人。Truly
precious, lovely in the sight of
God. Yeah. 那问题又来了，假如摩西长得很难看呢？So
here's the question: What if Moses was ugly?
那妈妈就说：“哎呀，反正那么丑啊，丢丢丢，你如何去了？”
Maybe the mother would say, oh, this baby is not so great, I'll just throw him away myself.
是因为俊美才把他留下来吗？
So did she keep him because of his physical beauty?
如果是这样，我们当中有许多人也可能丢到海里。
If this were really the case, then many of us would may throw away our children as well.
他不是用外面来看，外表看。
So of course, this beauty was not based on outward appearances.
In the sight of God, 是从上帝的角度来看。The
key word here is in the sight of God.
在一另外一处圣经啊，这个跟后面有关系，请耶和华对亚伯兰说：“你要确凿，你的后裔必寄居别人的地，又服侍那地的人。那地的人要苦待他们400年，并且他们所要服侍的那国，我要惩罚。后来他们必带着许多财物从那里。”好，这个里提到的。 耶和华对亚伯兰说：“你要的确知道，你的后裔寄居别人的地，别人的地是哪里？埃及，在那边服侍那埃及的人多少年？400年。然后神要把你们从那边带出来，所以刚好400年了。我不会讲太多了。”
So in the passage we just read, Genesis chapter 15, verses 13 and 14, God makes a promise to Abraham that his descendants will live in a foreign country, that they will be mistreated, but ultimately they will be able to escape. And they were, of course we know that the Israelites lived in Egypt for about 400 years.
所以呢，如果是一个近前的父母，他们会算。
So a woman of faith would keep this promise or prophecy into consideration.
上帝经过400年以后, 神要把我们带离开埃及。
We have a promise from God that after 400 years, God will lead us back out of Egypt.
耶基别是这个眼光来看,
So Jochebed took this into consideration when she decided to keep her baby.
所以在这个阶段所生的小孩, 都有可能上帝要选他成为民族英雄，成为领袖。
In other words, all the babies born during this time period had the possibility of being a leader that would bring the people out of Egypt.
所以无论如何，我一定要把它藏起来。
So in her mind, she thought, no matter what, I must keep this child safe.
有可能就是从我的孩子当中成就上帝的功。
It could be that through my child, God will do His miraculous works.
这不容易的。It's
not an easy thing to do.
就像耶稣生下来的时候一样，弥赛亚，弥赛亚。所以犹太的男人啊，每一天，所以为什么生男孩对他们来讲很大的歧视？
So just like when around the time of Jesus was born, the birth of a male is very important.
所以生男孩就有可能成为弥赛亚。Because
in theory, any male that is born could be the Messiah.
所以约基别有人称他是旧约的玛利亚。
So some people have even called Jochebed the Mary of the Old Testament.
她用这样的信心等候上帝，用信心生了孩子，用信心长子。
In faith, she waited on God's promise, and in faith, she bore the son.
这句话是大家都会的啊，常常背的。信就是所望之事的实底，是未见之事的，但不容易懂，对不对？因为翻译起来很拗口。
So in we all know this very famous verse from Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1, which says, Now faith is confidence in what we hope for, and assurance about what we do not see.
另外一种翻译,
there are other ways to translate this verse.
信心是对盼望的事有把握。
Sometimes we use synonyms like confidence or assurance.
对没有看见的事能肯定。
Being sure or having evidence of what you can't see.
约基别 一直盼望上帝的那一句应许。
So Jochebed had faith in God's promise.
有人在盼望，但是没把握。
Some people were hoping, but they didn't have that faith.
但约基别用信心等候盼望有把握。
But Jochebed had faith and trust and acted upon her belief.
所以今天我们看第一个这样的一个女性啊，活在一个这样的环境当中。
So we can see that with her faith, despite living in such a dangerous time period, she really lived out her faith.
所以第一个给我们一个提醒，我们是也像约西别有信心的人吗？
So this is a good reminder for us. Do we live out our lives of faith like Jochebed?
顺境的时候，我们做礼拜很好，聚会很好，奉献很好。
When times are good, we come to church, we offer and tithe, we go to Bible study, everything seems good.
但上帝突然给我们苦难了,
but when God suddenly allows troubles to come into our lives,
我们能不能仍然有这样的信心?
Can we still hold on to our faith?
约基别是在非常难处,非常不顺的环境当中。
Jochebed held on to her faith in perilous, troubling times.
所以我们今天坐在这里,看看别人信心的时候,省察我们。 是不是有信心的人?
So for all of us sitting here, when we hear about these stories of faith, we need to ask ourselves, do we have such a faith?
如果我们现在面对的挫折困难的时候，我们是否依然爱主，用信心等候神？
Can we still continue to love God, trust God, and wait on God during our difficult times?
第二个呢，它是我们审查的时候，我们现在看我们的光景，是否是继续追求属神的属性？
So we want to examine and test ourselves if we are continuing to be in Christ.
用信心不用嘴巴讲的。Faith
is not expressed just through
words. 信心更多的时候是我们的生活生命彰显出来的。Faith
is expressed in the way that we live our lives.
我们前几次讲的，听在前书里面，属神的人逃避那些不好的事，追求公义、敬虔跟什么信心。
We've recently been going through the book of 1 Timothy, and in chapter 6, verse 11, it says, You must pursue righteousness, godliness, and, of course, faith. So So we should ask ourselves, what is it that we're most concerned about right now?
是我们跟上帝的关系，我们用信心继续追求吗？
Is it our relationship with God, and are we using faith to pursue that relationship?
今天是母亲节，虽然是对母亲这么说。
So since today is it's Mother's Day, and of course we're talking about mothers.
但是对所有的弟兄姐妹一样。
But of course this applies to everyone.
让我们成为一个有信心的人。
Let us become people of faith.
第二个，他是一个行事有智慧的人。
Secondly, we see that Jochebed is a person of wisdom.
刚才圣经记载，我现在尝了三个月，孩子越来越大，尝不住了，怎么办？他就做了一个箱子。
So in the story, we read that she raised the child and hid the child for 3 months, but the child was getting bigger and bigger. So she asked, "What can I do?"
箱子在希伯来文里面跟方舟同义词。
So she built a basket, and the original word for basket actually is the same as the word for ark.
她想把孩子放在箱子里。
She decided to put the child in a basket.
那不能随便做啊！一放下去就开始沉下去。
Of course, any old basket would just sink in the water.
所以刚才圣经特别记载，她用石漆防水。
So the scripture specifically states that she took some pitch and tar.
然后用石油，就是柏油，啊，涂在里面。听说呢，他们讲这种味道是防止鳄鱼不喜欢，所以呢不会采取攻击。
So she coated the inside and outside with pitch and tar, and some people say that these chemicals were actually repellent to the crocodiles living in the Nile River.
用那个蒲草，好像做了一艘船一样的一个箱子。
And constructed a basket shaped like an ark.
然后放在河里。
And placed her child in the river.
这个是一个有智慧的女人啊。
This is a woman of great wisdom.
她没有说，哎，三个月反正已经没办法了，算了。丢掉了啊！上帝啊，你也知道，我已经等三个月，你还没有作为嘛，放弃了。
So she didn't simply give up just because, she didn't say to herself, "Well, I've tried for 3 months to keep the child hidden. Now it's too hard. I just give up. I leave the child in your hands, God."
把箱子放在水里，她仍然带着信心的。
So she had faith, and even though she placed the child in the basket.
所以安排姐姐在河边跟着看。
And she planned for the older sister to follow the basket.
看有什么问题，有什么情况，赶快报告，赶快处理。
To monitor the progress of the basket and to report back if necessary.
在上帝的计划里面，这个箱子就开始飘，就飘到了一个地方，刚好埃及法老的女儿跟一些使女在那边洗澡，河边玩水。
So by God's protection and guidance, this basket drifted over to a place where Pharaoh's daughters and her servants were bathing.
当这些使女把这孩箱子拿给公主看的时候，
So when the servants brought the basket over to Pharaoh's daughter,
打开来一看，是希伯来人的服装包的孩子。
They looked inside and saw this was a Hebrew child in Hebrew swaddling.
圣经用一句话感动他，可怜这个孩子。
The scriptures say that the princess took pity on the child.
就把他收为义子，要愿意抚养他。
And decided to adopt this child as her own.
姐姐马上跑过去。
At this moment, the older sister immediately came running forward.
因为可能公主还年轻。
So maybe the princess was still very young at this
point. 没结婚，当然没孩子。
Not yet wed, of course, didn't have any children of her own yet.
所以没有奶水喂养孩子。
So she had no milk to feed the child.
马上建议。
So this older sister immediately suggested.
我认识一个希伯来的妇女。
I know a Hebrew woman.
可以成为孩子的奶妈。
She can be the wet nurse for this child.
可不可以？
What do you think of this idea?
啊，公主马上说，哦，可以啊。
The princess said, "Oh, of course, sounds good."
你把她叫来。
Please bring her over here.
我还可以付工资给她。
I'll even pay wages to her.
你发现吗？上帝掌管了一切的作为。
So do you see how God is taking control and king of this entire situation?
不但免除了孩子生命的危险。
Not only did he save the child from harm.
变成一个安全的喂养，而且还可以领工钱。
This child is now living in a safe environment, and the mother is being paid wages as well.
这不是重点，问题就来了。
This is not the main point. Here's the problem. Here's the question.
姐姐家认为这个摩西的姐姐大概大她六岁、八岁之间。
So Bible scholars believe that Moses' older sister was probably about 6 years older than Moses.
想想看，当这个小箱子漂流的时候，这个六七八岁的孩子能做什么？
So if we think about it, as this basket is floating along, what can this 6 or 7 year old kid do?
碰到了埃及法老女儿的时候, 他怎么有这个聪明说, 我认识一个奶妈, 介绍了。
So when the basket was picked up by the princess, would a typical child have the intelligence to come up with such a plan?
你们家有天才孩童吗?
Do you guys have super smart children?
显然，所以有学者认为。 所有后面整个的计划都在妈妈主导。
So scholars believe that this entire plan, these ideas were actually all planned by the mother herself.
遇到什么情况你怎么做，遇到情况你怎么说等等。所以这个孩子能够这样的表达，是约基别的智慧。So
in other words, the mother planned out everything in the case of any scenario. She taught the child how to be prepared for any situation.
这是一个有智慧的妇人。
So this is an example of a mother of wisdom.
智慧跟知识我们常要分别，当然圣经有很多时候把它通用。
So we should be able to differentiate between wisdom and knowledge, even though sometimes the Bible lumps them together.
知识是对客观事物的认知。
So knowledge is acknowledging or knowing about some objective truths.
但智慧呢？
But how about wisdom?
是对那个事物有正确的反应跟判断跟分辨。
Wisdom is more like having proper insight or judgment about the reality.
我懂得很多的知识做原子弹。
I may have a lot of knowledge and I can use it to create an atomic bomb.
但什么时候按就要有智慧了。
But when can I use it? That requires judgment.
分辨的洞察力，那是智慧。
The ability to judge, to tell the difference, that is wisdom.
知识可以藏在人的脑中。
Knowledge lives inside a person's mind.
智慧却在人的心里。
Wisdom lives in a person's heart.
知识可以丰富人的大脑。
Knowledge can greatly expand one's intellect.
智慧却丰富人的品格。
But wisdom shapes a person's character.
知识会叫人家骄傲。
Knowledge can make people proud.
但智慧会叫人谦卑。
Wisdom teaches people to be humble.
知识可以透过学习积少成多。
Intelligence can be acquired through lots of learning.
但你发现智慧却来自于真理的源头。
But wisdom comes directly from the source of all knowledge.
所以怎么知道你拥有智慧呢？
So how do we know if we have this knowledge?
我们一起念箴言9:10.
This will be Proverbs.
敬畏耶和华是智慧的开端，认识知识的便是聪明。所有的真理。 智慧、聪明都来自于上帝。All
wisdom comes from God.
一个人敬畏神，神就启发他、启示他，啊，赏赐他智慧。When
a person reveres and fears God, then God will grant them this wisdom.
约基别所以有智慧，源于他对神的信心，对于神的敬畏。We
know that Jochebed feared and revered God, so God gave her the wisdom she needed.
所以我们都当成为一个敬畏上帝的人，得到智慧。
So we should all be people that revere and fear God in order to receive this wisdom.
第二个怎么得着呢？
How do we receive this wisdom?
诚心求。
We must ask with sincerity.
合神的心意求。
According to God's will.
雅各书1:5，请你们中间若有缺少智慧，应当求那后赐与众人，也不是神的神，神就必赐给，主会赐给我们智慧。
James chapter 1 verse 5 says, if any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, give generously to all.
但是前提必须符合神的心意。
Of course, it should be according to God's will.
你不能求一个智慧做神不喜欢的事。
Of course, you can't ask for wisdom to do things that God doesn't want you to do.
当所罗门求上帝给智慧的时候，他后面的动机是什么？
When Solomon asked God for wisdom, what was his motivation?
他说让我有智慧管理。
He said, Lord, give me wisdom so that I can manage your people.
这个是合神心意的。
This was according to God's will.
所以上帝给他智慧。
So God gave him this wisdom.
也给他财富。
And gave him wealth.
所以我们如果合神的心意，大胆的向神求，主就赐给我们。
So when we boldly ask for wisdom, which is according to God's will, God will definitely give it to us.
第三，要与主连结。
Lastly, we should be abiding in Christ, in God.
这一节经节可能我们比较熟, 常会忽略啊，我们一起念经。但你们得在基督耶稣里是本乎神，神又使他成为我们的智慧、公义、圣洁、救赎。他是指谁？神又使他成为我们的智慧，谁？基督。所以今天如果我们说我们敬畏神，那是敬畏的基督是住在礼拜堂呢，还是住在我们的心里？他就成为你的智慧。
So in the 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 30 it says, it is because of him that you are in Christ Jesus who has become for us wisdom from God. So in other words, Jesus has to live in us in order for us to have wisdom.
所以我们常常跟主建立美好的关系，枝子与葡萄树的那个比喻一样，一样可以从主得到智慧。
We want to develop a strong relationship with God, just like the analogy of Jesus being the vine and we are the branches, so that we can directly get this wisdom from God.
所以各位，今天我们是有智慧的人吗？
So brothers and sisters, are we people of wisdom?
自己讲不算。
Doesn't count if you say it yourself.
有一个圣经节，真正有智慧，如果我们得着从上头来上帝给我们的智慧，我们会反映出一些的生命。
So when we get wisdom, wisdom can be expressed in the following ways:
清洁、和平、温良、柔顺、怜悯、节善果，没有偏见，没有假冒。
So from the scriptures, James chapter 3, we can see that wisdom that comes from heaven is first of all pure, then peace-loving, considerate, submissive, full of mercy and good fruit, impartial and sincere.
所以这个智慧不只是好像做事情好像很聪明，很多手段，很多方法达到目的，达到结果，不是。
So wisdom is not just about showing intelligence and being able to plan a lot of things and appearing to be very smart.
真正的智慧更反映出属灵的生命。
So true wisdom is manifest or shown in the fruits of the Spirit, how we live our lives.
所以可以检视自己是一个有智慧的人。
So we can ask ourselves if we are people of wisdom.
这是古希腊的哲学家柏克里特斯。
There was an ancient Greek philosopher called Democritus.
他说呢，一个人真正有没有智慧，有三个结果看出来。
He said that there are three ways to tell whether a person is wise or not.
第一，他的思考周到，很详尽，很周详。
First of all, this person thinks is very thoughtful and considerate in how he thinks.
第二个，他的言语得当。如同金苹果在银网子里，什么时候说什么样的话。
Secondly, their speech is proper.
第三，行为公正。
And lastly, their actions are just and righteous.
我想跟圣经原则很像。
This is very much in accordance with the principles of the scriptures.
约基别不只是懂得去做个箱子。
So Jochebed didn't just know how to make a basket.
相信他的生命也是像刚才所讲的许多合神心意的品格。
We believe that her life really was lived in accordance to these principles as well.
听姐妹，你现在先想一下。
Brothers and sisters, let us think about this.
当米利安这个姐姐回来告诉她说，公主收养的弟弟。
When the older sister Miriam came back to her and said, a princess adopted my little brother.
你是那个妈妈，你会怎么想
？If you were the mother, how would you feel?
老天有眼
，God is truly watching over us.
机会来了
，Here's my chance.
现在又让我乃这个摩西，我来教育他。
Not only can I feed my own child, I can also teach him.
如果约基别是一个功利主义者
，So if Jochebed was a utilitarian sort of person.
他会教摩西好好珍惜这个身份。
She would teach Moses to really, really appreciate his elevated position.
好好的学习。
To educate himself well.
有一天要在埃及做法老王。
And perhaps one day he could even become the Pharaoh of Egypt.
只要目的，手段不要管他。
As long as you have the right objectives, it doesn't matter how you do it.
但约基别没有这样做。
But of course, she didn't teach her son that way.
他教到的是信仰。
She taught him about faith.
所以呢，我们看见他是用生活、用生命感染摩西的。
So she used her life and her character to really bring up her son.
所以希伯来书就用这样来形容摩西的信心从哪里来的。
So this is where Moses' faith came from.
他说宁愿与自己的百姓受苦，也不愿意享受最终之乐。
Scriptures describe Moses' faith this way. He chose to be mistreated along with the people of God rather than to enjoy the pleasures of sin.
宁可跟自己的百姓站在一起，他不羡慕埃及法老的王位。
He would rather stand with his own people instead of stand with the Egyptians.
不要忘了，他到断奶，一般的通常当时的社会，三岁让断奶。
Just some historical context. In those days, children were weaned. They stopped breastfeeding around the age of 3 or 4.
稍微特殊的，有到5岁才断奶。
And possibly even the age of 5.
那现在我们的1岁都断奶了啊。
Now, of course, children stop breastfeeding after about 1 year of.
意思是什么？这个约基别就利用3年到5年的时间，他把摩西教育出一个有信仰、有品格的好领袖。
The point is this, within this 3 or 5 years that she had with her son, she taught her son to be a person of faith, a person of character.
5岁一直到40岁，摩西是在埃及的教育、埃及的这个环境中长大的。
So from the age of 5 to 40, Moses grew up in the Egyptian educational system, Egyptian culture.
但是你发现那个影响，显然他选择的时候选择母亲带给他的影响。
But in the end, we see that when it came for him to make a decision, he made his choice based on what his mother taught him.
是摩西在3岁5岁之间奠定了信仰的根基。
He made his decision based on the strong principles, teachings that he learned from his mother.
约基别不只是一个奶妈。
So Jochebed was not just a wet nurse.
更是摩西的心灵导师。
She was. She was a life coach, a true role model for her son.
华人讲一句话嘛，3岁看大，7岁看老，对不对？
There's a Chinese saying that at the age of 3, you can tell what a child will be like as an adult, and at the age of 7, you can pretty much predict how they will be when they are very old.
讲英文的听得懂吗？ 所以很多孩子的一生啊，我们不要以为是20岁，念大学我才开始形成他的性格。So
as parents, it's a mistake for us to think, okay, now that my child is in college, now he will truly learn to be an adult.
3岁5岁看大。
Around the age of 3 and 5, these are the foundational years.
有一次跟孩子孙子孙女们吃饭，我们说哎， let's pray, 我们祷告。
So we get kids together before mealtime, we'll say, let's all pray together.
3岁半的孙女说，我今天是我。
And then a three-year-old grandchild says, today is my turn.
假如家里没有习惯这种祷告，他会不会说，我不会。
So if this child wasn't brought up in an environment where people learn to pray, would she volunteer to do so?
所以孩子什么时候学会祷告，学会敬虔，学会尊重上帝，都在小时候培养。
So when is it that children learn to obey God, to love God, to revere God? It's all during these early years.
约基别用自己的生命生活影响摩西。
Jochebed used her own life, her own example, to influence her son Moses.
了不起。
Impressive.
因为她生了3个孩子。
She had 3 kids in all.
第一个做以色列人的大祭司。
The first one became the high priest of Israel.
生的女儿。
The daughter, Miriam.
成为犹太妇女中的领袖先知。
She became a leader in the women of Israel and also a prophetess.
生的小儿子摩西。
The youngest son Moses.
是把200万以色列人带离开埃及的英雄。
Was the hero of Israel who brought two million of them out of Egypt into the promised land.
妈妈多重要。
How important a mother is.
所以犹太的谚语有一句话。
So there's a saying in Israel.
一个好母亲胜过100所学校。A
good mother is worth more than 100 schools.
所以我们今天150个母亲，我们已经胜过好多的学校。Yeah,
so all the mothers here, we are, you in total, you are greater than so many schools.
美国的总统当中
among all the American presidents,
家境最好，环境最好是哪一位？
Who grew up in the most affluent?
美国的总统当中，甘乃迪。
Kennedy.
他是很有钱的一个朋
友。Yeah, he grew up in a very wealthy and powerful.
最穷，学历最低的是哪一位？
Who was the poorest and had the worst education?
Reagan.
Lincoln.
Abraham Lincoln.
Lincoln. 他读了小学一二年级就休学。
So the limit of his education was elementary school.
家里穷得不行了。
His family was extremely poor.
更可怜的是十一岁那一年父母双亡。
Even more tragic, around that time, both his parents died.
妈妈临终离世前把林肯叫到身边。
Before his mother passed away, she called him to her bedside.
我没有留下什么给你。
She told him, I don't have anything to give.
但有一个东西要留给你。
But one thing I do want to leave.
就是这本圣经。
This Bible.
这是教你做人。认识神的真理的一本书。
This book will teach you to understand the truth and to obey God.
希望你按着圣经的真理而活。
I hope that you will live according to this book.
林肯就任总统的时候。
So when Lincoln was sworn in and inaugurated as president,
他从他口袋里拿出了这一本妈妈留下的圣经。
He swore the presidential oath based on this his mother's copy of the Bible.
他接受记者的访问说：“我今天所以成为总统。”
And so he said to reporters, "Today I become president."
就是我母亲留给我的这本书。
The reason for this is because of the Bible that my mother has given.
有一天，我们有孩子会离开我们。
So one day our children will leave us.
我们想把孩子塑造成什么样的一个人
？What kind of people do we want our children to be?
我们现在比较关心的是哈佛、耶鲁，什么样的好学校？
So maybe we're more concerned about what kind of top schools they're going to be attending.
啊，如果今天有什么样的讲座什么，只要对孩子的都拉出去。
So if there's any events or training or that can boost their education, we're going to take our kids there.
但多少时候孩子有了世上的知识、学位、地位。
But quite often our children may be able to acquire this knowledge, this fame, this power.
他失去的是为人的本分、品格。对神的尊重
but they don't necessarily have the character, this understanding of God.
我今天本来想讲，我想怕时间不够，我又没有留下来。他说，在美国的青少年离开教会原因比例那么高，有几个原因找。
So today we see a trend in which the young people are leaving the church in record numbers.
好几个都是母亲不在乎信仰对他的影响。
So one of the main reasons is because the parents don't really care about or are not very concerned about their children's faith.
经常缺席。
So,
组织崇拜，接着常常说不来。
They're always absent and don't attend Sunday worship.
来也迟到。
When they come, they're late.
就我就大概印象最深刻就这两个啊。但是你想想看，如果你那个小孩，你叫他说要爱主啊，要你知道他是假的。
So under such circumstances, when you ask the children if they love God or not, it's probably just an act for them.
我们关心的常常是哪一方面，孩子都看在眼里，放在心里。
Yeah, so we really need to take into consideration what the children are learning and whether they're really taking it into their heart.
我们看摩西有三个四十年，对不对？第一个四十年在埃及，第二个四十年在米甸旷野，后面四十年带领以色列出埃及。
So we see that Moses' life can be broken up into three 40-year periods. The first was the 40 years in Egypt. The second 40-year period bringing Israel out of Egypt. In the 40 years in the wilderness, and then finally the 40 years in the wilderness, leading Israel to the Promised Land.
没有错，后面最后神训练了八十年以后，最后四十年是最有成就的四十年。
So on one hand, we can say during the last 40 years, that was the time of Moses' greatest accomplishments.
但是影响他八十年，却是第一个四十年。
But the last 80 years were determined by the first 40 years.
而且是第一个四十年的前景。
And in fact, it was determined by the first few years of the first 40-year period.
信仰的根基何等重要。
So the roots of faith are so important.
端看妈妈如何在这张白纸孩子身上画上什么样的图画。
So children are like a blank piece of paper. You can see how the mother influenced or wrote upon this paper with her example of faith.
今天早上站出来大概30到40个孩子唱歌。
So this morning we had about 30 to 40 kids up here performing their songs.
如果按照教会今天的统计。
If according to the statistics in the church,
我们当中的孩子长大以后有2/3离开神。
According to current trends, 2/3 of the children who are standing up here may possibly leave the church when they grow up.
也就是说，今天看起来这么可爱的这些孩子唱歌的时候，在20年离开主。
So, all these cute kids up here performing and singing, in 20 years, many of them won't be in church anymore, possibly.
让自己成为有见证的妈妈。
Let us be parents who live a life who are role models.
有一个在东京的犹太妇女带着孩子去百货公司买衣服。
So there was once a Jewish mother who brought her child to the store.
当买完回到家把盒子打开的时候
，When she got home and opened the package,
突然发现盒子里面多了一个戒指。
She noticed a ring inside the package.
这个穷犹太妇女一看到戒指
，So this poor mother saw this precious diamond ring.
我没骗，没偷，没抢。
I didn't steal. I didn't deceive.
她自己出现的。
This diamond just appeared in my package.
所以有一点想占为己有。
So she wanted to take advantage of this unexpected gift.
但是有不安，可能在自己的信仰当中成长。
But her conscience troubled her a little still.
就带着孩子去问社区里面的拉比老师。
So she took her child and went to see the rabbi.
拉比听完以后，没有直接回答他可以不可以。
So after listening to her story, the rabbi did not directly tell her whether she could or could not keep this ring.
就讲一个故事给她听。
So instead, he told her a story.
从前有一个拉比。
Once upon a time, there was another rabbi.
他上课上得很好。
He was a great teacher.
但是犹太人不能靠教书养生。
But in the Jewish culture, people did not make a living off of being a teacher.
所以他还要去砍柴、劈柴、卖柴来养活自己。
So he had to work as a woodcutter to cut the wood, gather the wood, sell the wood in order to support himself.
他就太累了。
So he thought this life is too exhausting.
存了一些钱。
So he saved up some money.
想买一头驴。
In order to buy a donkey.
将来砍完柴以后，让驴拖到市场去卖。
So that once he chops the wood, he can put the wood on the donkey can then carry the wood to the marketplace.
可以省很多的体力，然后有更多的时间浇水。
So of course it would make it easier for him to do his work and he would have more energy to teach students.
带着学生徒弟去买玩具回来的时候叫学生说搓搓的到河边洗干净。
So he and his students went to buy a donkey and they took the donkey to the river to give this donkey a bath.
当这些徒弟在洗刷驴身体的时候从他的佩环上轰隆掉了一颗钻石。
So while the students were giving this donkey a good scrub,attached to the donkey, out popped out the diamond.
徒弟很高兴啊。
The students were overjoyed.
上帝如此爱我们。
Well, God truly loves us.
让我们的老师可以专心更多时间教课。
Now our teacher, with this wealth, he can now completely focus on teaching us.
所以马上把驴牵回去。老师，老师，好消息。你买的这一批驴附赠了一个钻石。
So he said, "Teacher, teacher, you bought this donkey, but God has given you a diamond in addition to that."
所以学生就讲，洗的时候掉下来啊，我们也没偷没抢啊，就这应该是我们没人知道嘛。
So they explained, "If this diamond just was attached to the donkey somehow, so we didn't steal it, we didn't lie for it, so this is our gift to us."
拉比听完。
So the rabbi heard this.
走。
He said, "Let's go."Where?
回到阿拉伯商人那里去。
Back to the marketplace where the Arabian.
把钻石还给他。
And we're going to return the diamond to the seller.
啊，徒弟们很不谅解，不理解。
Students were amazed, shocked.
他说在犹太人我们的观念里面, 我只买属于我的东西。
So the rabbi said, we as Jews, when we buy, we only buy what we intended to buy.
我只买，我没买钻石，所以钻石不应该属于我。
I didn't intend to purchase a diamond, therefore the diamond does not belong to me.
徒弟就想，这个老师真的脑子有问题哦。
The students thought this teacher is a little too, something's wrong with him.
100个不情愿跟着老师回去。
So very begrudgingly, they followed the rabbi.
阿拉伯商人也很讶异啊，哎，你这怎么会拿回来还呢？
So the Jared seller was totally bewildered as well. He said, why would you return such a thing to me?
没有人知道吗?
No one knows that you have it.
然后你只讲一句话,
the rabbi only said one word in response.
因为我是犹太人。
I'm Jewish, that's two words.
阿拉伯这个商人直接从口中冒出一句话,
so the seller said this in response.
你的神是世上最伟大的神。
Your God is the world's greatest God.
当讲完了以后，妇女一听完，啊，老师，我懂了。
So after hearing the story, the mother said, "Okay, I understand."
明天我就把这个戒指拿回到百货公司还给他们。
Tomorrow I'll take this diamond ring and return it to the department store.
如果他们会讲啊，你怎么那么笨啊？你怎么为什么要还呢？没人知道啊。那我要怎么回答？
But then she asked, if the people at the store ask me, oh, why would you return this? How can you be so silly? What should I say?
你只讲一句话。
Rabbi said, you should just say one thing.
我是犹太人。
I am a Jewish person.
好，谢谢。 转身要走的时候。
So when she turned to leave,
等等，孩子。
The rabbi said, wait just a minute.
明天要去还的时候。
Tomorrow when you go to return the diamond,
记得带上你的孩子。
Please remember to bring your son.
让你的孩子知道,
let your son know,
我的母亲不贪小便宜。
My mother is not a, someone who, my mother is not a deceitful.
我的母亲敬畏上帝。
My mother reveres God.
我的母亲正直的人。
My mother is just.
你可能一个行动, 这样的行为影响孩子一生。
One little action can influence your child for the rest of their life.
所以我们第三个，我们说，我们盼望像约基别用自己的生命教导、影响孩子，盼望今天在母亲节的时候，再一次神把这个责任给我们。So
on this Mother's Day, we hope that the example of Jochebed will remind all of us, not just the mothers, to live a life that, as a role model, to inspire our children.
约基别的意思，活出上帝的荣耀。The
meaning of Jochebed is to means the glory of God.
培养自己对神的信心。
We need to cultivate our own faith.
从哪里来呢？信心， 从上帝的话来。
Where does faith come from? From God's word.
神所讲的应许， 我们确信不疑。
Let us hold on to God's promises as written in the scripture.
培养自己有智慧行事。
Let us grow in wisdom.
从哪里来呢？
Where does wisdom come from?
从我们谦卑敬畏神而来。
It comes when we humbly revere and fear God.
第三个，培养自己的生活要有榜样。
And lastly, we must live as role models.
从我们的生命中传递。
Let us be models in not only in speech but in action, how we live our lives.
祝福天下的母亲。
Blessings to all the mothers out there.
每个人都剩100所学校。
May all of you exceed 100 schools.
那今天当父亲的，不要以为只是讲给他们听。
All fathers, don't think that this lesson is not for you.
这也是我们的责任。
This is also our responsibility.
我们来唱这首诗歌，晋升，晋升，一起站立上。